Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Jaime here. Today I'm making drunken noodles. So this is the quickest, easiest noodle dish that you're ever likely to make. And it really doesn't have so many ingredients. So this is what I've got. I've got some onion, chili, garlic that's just been chopped up. I've got some bok choy that's just one head cut up and washed. And then I've got some chicken that is thinly sliced, half a breast, and we're just cutting it really thin so it cooks quicker. You don't want big chunks, and also when it ties in with the noodles, the smaller it is, it will just be able to stick to those noodles, and then you won't have big pieces of chicken at the bottom of the bowl when you're almost finished. So with this one, I'm just gonna put over some fish sauce and leave that in there. And then I've got some rice noodles. So the rice noodles are really quick to cook. You just pour boiling water over them and then drain them. So when I was working for Prince Jeffrey, we always had these in the fridge, so you can literally just grab and serve them something within minutes. So this is a really popular dish. So all we've got to do is soak these, make up the dressing, and then we're ready to jump into the pan. So I'm just gonna throw these into a bowl. I've already boiled the kettle, so we can just grab that and then literally just gonna pour it over. And by the time you've chopped up your onion, chili, then that will be ready to go straight into the pan. For the dressing, I've got some palm sugar. I'm just gonna make one portion. So one sleeve is one portion. Normally those rice noodles, pad thai noodles, they come in a packet of two, which will obviously be two portions. So as I'm just making the one portion, I'm gonna use half of one of these cubes of palm sugar. If you can't find palm sugar or haven't got it, then you can use honey or maple syrup or even just straight up sugar. And then we can go in oyster sauce, so 2 tablespoons of oyster sauce. I'm just going to eyeball it. Two tablespoons of soy sauce and 1 tablespoon of dark soy sauce. If you haven't got dark soy sauce, then you can use ketchup manis. That will work, which is Indonesian soy sauce. And that is it. That's our dressing made. We can just give that a mix. The palm sugar will break down when it goes into the pan and you apply the heat if it doesn't do it. But you can just, if you just press it and give it a mix, then that will be good to go. So normally, drunken noodles is loaded with garlic. I've gone pretty light here. There's only a couple of cloves of garlic and then one chili. Normally it's got Thai chili in just to give it that extra power packing punch of heat. So I've really gone for the light touch of chili, and that's really because I did a poll on my Instagram and it was 50-50 on light or spicy. So I just decided to do it light, and then you can ramp it up from there. So that's everything we need. I've got some Thai basil here as well, so we can just jump straight into the pan. Okay, so as always, the first thing we're gonna do is fire up the pan. I'm gonna use peanut oil, but you can use whatever oil that you want. Just try not to use olive oil because it has a very low smoke point, so you're not gonna get enough heat in it before it starts to burn. And then once we've got some heat in here, we can go in with our onion, chili, and garlic. Just gonna fry that off, put the chicken in. The chicken is gonna be seconds, so it's gonna be super, super quick. My noodles have softened up nicely. The oil is flowing nicely. So we can go in with our chili, garlic mix. You can always use shallots if you prefer shallots. They're a lighter, more delicate flavor. Fry those off. Then we just fry that off for a minute. Oh, the chili catches you. You can go straight in with our chicken. Just make sure that you separate it all so it's not sticking together, so you can get a nice even cook on there. And then I've got my bok choy to go in, but you can use whatever you want, zucchinis or Chinese cabbage, whatever you want really, just to get some Asian greens in there. And I'm just using these ones because they cook really, really quick. So you can see we're starting to get some color on that chicken, which is good. So this can go in. And that is only going to cook for about a minute and it will all be ready, and then we can just drop in our noodles and it will be cracking. So that's nicely cooked down, so we can go in with our noodles. You can strain them off if you want, but this water will release some of the flavours that are on the bottom of the pan, and they will come back into the pan, and you'll see that these noodles will start to colour. So it's already starting to dye the noodle. And you want that because it just makes it look so much more appetizing. So when we go in with our sauce, we're gonna get a really nice dark flavor and it's just gonna look a lot more appealing. So that's it. As soon as the noodles go in, you just wanna cook them until they're hot. Because once this goes in, it's gonna increase the temperature because of the sugars in there and having the liquid. So once that goes in, the temperature is going to increase, so it will be piping hot when you serve it. And that is it. So I can just turn off the heat. We've got our handful of Thai basil that can go in. Just give it a lovely freshness. So just make sure it's broken up. You don't need to chop it up or anything. Just want to break it up because it's all just going to wilt in and just be through the dish. So you don't even need to cook it. Just the heat of the pan will be plenty. So, and that is it. So that is probably one of the quickest noodle dishes that rates highly on the flavour front that you're ever going to make. So, boom. Dinner for one. It's a pretty tasty number. So, we'll grab our chopsticks and chow down. So, boom. Wow, so good. That Thai basil gives it a great aniseed flavour. So if you don't like aniseed, then just use regular basil, but this really is packed with flavour. So give it a go. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell when I put my next video up. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram so you can grab and screenshot my recipe cards. And until the next one, happy cooking, and I'll see you there.